When the axon is in resting state, then the membrane is having more of positive charge toward the outer side and negatively charged towards the inner side. The concentration of sodium and potassium ions is also different on the outer and inner side. Both sodium and potassium are positively charged ions, but sodium ions are more toward the outer side and potassium ions are more toward the inner side. In the membrane, there is sodium-potassium pump present, which is continuously working. Due to working of sodium-potassium pump, 3 sodium ions are moved out and 2 potassium ions are moved in by utilizing 1 ATP. So that means every time 3 positive ions are moving out and 2 positive ions are moving in. So because of that, there is a positive charge developed on the outer side. Because of this, because membrane is having positive charge toward the outer side and negative charge toward the inner side, the membrane becomes polar. Polar means where there is displacement of charge. This state of membrane is called as polarized. When the neuron is in resting stage, then its potential across the membrane, potential difference across the membrane is -70 millivolt. That means that the difference in the total charge between the inside and outside of the membrane is -70 millivolt. Or in other words, we can say that inside of the membrane is 70 millivolt more negative as compared to the outer side. This state of the membrane is called as polarized, and at this state there is more of positive charge on the outer side, and as there is more of sodium ion present on the outer side. This is the resting stage of the plasma membrane and it is polarized. But what happens when the neuron receives a stimulus? Dendrites, they may be receiving the stimulus, and this stimulus, if it is accumulated to threshold potential at the axon hillock, then the neuron is fired. Or in other words, we can say that neuron, it generates a nerve impulse. Threshold potential is equal to -55 millivolt. At this state, what happens? That sodium channels, they open. Because of opening of sodium channel, the membrane becomes freely permeable to sodium ions, and more sodium ions, they move toward the inside of the membrane. So when sodium ions, which are positively charged, they are moving toward the inner side, so what will happen? A state will reach when the potential difference across the membrane becomes zero. This state, when the membrane is having no potential difference across it, is called as fully depolarized. So this is happening because of the movement of positively charged sodium ions or due to opening of sodium channels. But this doesn't stop here. Because sodium channels are still open, so more and more sodium ion, it keeps on coming in. Because of that, action potential, it reaches up to +30 millivolt. That means now the membrane is positively charged toward the inner side and negatively charged toward the outer side. This state is called as repolarization. So that means depolarization means when the membrane potential across the plasma membrane is zero, that is fully depolarized. But repolarization means when the polarity gets reversed. Because of movement of more and more sodium ion toward the inner side, positive charge develops on the inner side of the membrane and negative charge develops on the outer side. So again, there is differentiation in the charge across the membrane. That means membrane is polarized, but it is reversed in direction. Initially, when the membrane was polarized, then it was positive outside, negative inside. when it is getting repolarized, then it is getting opposite charge developed. Now it is positive inside and negative outside. At this stage, when the action potential is reached, action potential means when potential difference across the membrane is plus 30 millivolt, then another channel opens, that is the potassium gates. Potassium is always more toward the inner side of the membrane. So when potassium gates open, potassium starts moving out. Potassium is also positively charged. So in a way, the positive charge is moving out. When more and more potassium will move out, the membrane will again get negative inside. That means it will get polarized. So this state is just similar to the first stage when membrane is positively charged outside and negatively charged outside. When this happens, then the sodium channel, they are open but they become inactive. That means that though the sodium channels are open, but they are not able to transport the sodium ions. Because of this, the action potential never shoots more than 30 millivolt. Because when the action potential is reached, then sodium channels, they stop moving sodium ions. That means only at that potential, potassium gates open, and now the charges, they are being moved because of the potassium gates. Another state reaches when the membrane gets hyperpolarized. This happens because potassium gates are very slow to react. Due to repolarization, the membrane potential drops to minus 70 millivolt. But at that potential, potassium gates do not shut. They are slow in shutting down. Because of that, more and more potassium keeps on moving out. Now, when more and more potassium is moving out, then the potential difference will drop lower than minus 70 millivolt. It can drop up to minus 75 millivolt. So this state, when the membrane is more negatively charged towards inner side, is called as hyperpolarized. Hyperpolarized state of plasma membrane is achieved because of slow activity of potassium gates, as they are not able to shut at minus 70 millivolt, so potential drops to minus 75 millivolt. So this is the state when the membrane is getting hyperpolarized, then at 70 millivolt, sodium channels, they become active again and they shut. So this is the state when, if there is further more stimulus received, then sodium channels will be able to open again. So this is how the movement of sodium and potassium ion is controlling the activity of neuron. Neuron can receive a stimulus only when sodium channels are open. When sodium channel is open but inactive, then it cannot receive the stimulus. So that means when the membrane is repolarized, or when the membrane is having potential across the action potential, then it will not be able to receive the stimulus. But when it is hyperpolarized, then if a stimulus of potential difference more than threshold potential is received, then the membrane or the neuron, it can fire another nerve impulse. So this is how the working of plasma membrane helps in generating the nerve impulse. Then when the membrane is at minus 70 millivolt, then the sodium potassium pump, because it is continuously working, it restores the potential to minus 70 millivolt, so that next nerve impulse may be generated.